السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. I wish you عيد مبارك today for all of you إن شاء الله. After this long marathon of fasting, the 30 days of Ramadan, Alhamdulillah, Ramadan was the month of mercy, forgiveness, and being protected from the hellfire. Alhamdulillah. أوله رحمة وأوسطه مغفرة وآخره عتق من النار. And I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah has accepted all your prayer, your fasting, your charity, and all your work during this very blessed days of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, particularly in the last 10 days when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told us and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told us to observe the night of power, which is when you worship it, it's equivalent to 83 months of what we know of our time in this life. So Eid is not going to be Eid unless we bring happiness to not only to ourselves, to our children, to our family, to our relatives, to our friends, to our neighbors, whether our neighbors are Muslims or non-Muslims, to our people, wherever they are, to our country, to anybody, to let them to share the blessing of the Eid and the happiness and the joy of the Eid. It's not going to be Eid for all of us unless we do that to everybody around us. It's not going to be Eid unless we remember and do pray and do support our people in Palestine, in Jerusalem, in Gaza, in the Rohingya people, the Indian people who are suffering from Corona badly nowadays, the Kashmiri people in India as well, the Uyghur people, the Syrian, the Yemeni, the Iraqi, the South Sudanese, the Muslims and non-Muslim community, the people of Democratic Republic of Congo that I keep saying, talking about them every now and then, that the people of Central African Republic, that the people of Gambia, of Lesotho, of Botswana, of Afghanistan, Pakistan, Bangladesh, everywhere, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims. You need to remember the goodwill and the good wish to all of these people that around us, and that's actually how can you bring Eid to everyone. Eid to bring it home where you are living, as well as to send the blessing of your prayer and charity to everyone all over the place, inshallah, to the people of Eritrea with nobody supporting them, and all these people, inshallah. Eid is not going to be Eid unless we wish peace, tranquility, safety, happiness, and joy to anyone and everyone on this planet, whether they are Muslims or non-Muslims, whether we think that they are our friends or think that some of them could be our enemy. We should wish for them the good, wishful thinking of our Eid, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us a good guidance to all of us, so we can live in peace together on this planet, inshallah, before we meet with Him. For us, as the Prophet ﷺ said, have two happiness or two joys. One of them is on the day of the Eid, when we actually break the fasting and bring this happiness and to share it with all our relatives and friends and neighborhood. Actually, the second one, which is when we meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because fasting, it was the only pillar of Islam when it's secretive, by intention. So Allah will look at our hearts and see how good the reward we are going to get when we meet with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet said, Allah said, and actually, كل عمل ابن آدم, all the action or the acts of the son of Adam and the daughter of Adam is for him. It's seen. يعني you go to the mosque and pray, everybody sees you, you give charity outside, you make hajj, you see it. And actually, for each blessing, for each act, good act you do, you have got 10 blessings or 700 blessings or more than that, as much as Allah wants to multiply. The only one, nobody knows about how much is the reward of such a worship is fasting itself. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, all the acts of Adam, son of Adam, or the daughter of Adam, is for them. They know the reward of it and they can measure it. The only thing that nobody will know anything about it is fasting. I am the one who is going to reward you, my sister, or you, my the Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to reward you, our sister or our brothers, on the day of judgment. Because you know what Allah will say? He or she left drinking, eating, and become tired, having headache and backache, and left all this leisure for me. That's why I'm going to bring all this happiness and joy in the day of judgment, or when you meet with me, when I die, inshallah. And this is what we say. So remember, during the day of Eid, everyone, anywhere, everywhere, whether they are Muslims, whether they are our relatives, our friends, or our colleagues, or people sometimes we think that they could be our enemies, to pray for them, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala change them from being our enemies to be our friends on this day of Eid, inshallah. So please, 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 on that day, remember everybody in need, the sick, the displaced, the refugees, the widows, the orphans, the disabled people, the disabled children, and the homeless people, and yani people who have nowhere to go or lost, please. And if you cannot do anything for them, just at least pray for them. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Eid Mubarak to all of you. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.